Screen TV, brought to you by TCU Financial Group. We'll help get you there.
I think this will be your last contract?
I don't know. I hope so. But a couple more years would be nice, and just kind of left up to them at this point. I'm getting a little old, but I'm happy back.
How does a guy keep coming back year after year?
I have no idea. I don't know how. I keep sneaking in, but I guess just because I've been here so long and they know what I can do and good veteran presence. But you know, I'm no Dressler, but I think I can get the job done. So.
But to hit that number of 10 years, that's a pretty significant number, isn't it?
Yeah, it is. It's good. You know, I know when I first came to the league, I always thought 10 years was a pretty big number, and now I'm going to 11. Yes, yeah, yeah. So who cares now, eh?
But, you're not getting too old for this.
No, this Hughesy's aging way worse than I am, so you'll see when he gets in front of the camera. He's decrepit. No, I feel pretty good. You know, the body felt good last year. Hughesy and I are actually just working out and talking about it, and we feel pretty good leading into next year already. So.
Does it take extra work, though, to keep it at this level, or is it...
Extra rest time, I think.
Extra rest time?
Yeah, you just... the workouts kind of hit you a little harder in the off-season, so you got to make sure you get your rest, and I got to get my kids in bed early so I get in bed early myself.
What role do you see yourself doing next year? Same role, diminished, maybe
all pro. CFL all pro, I'm thinking. I really want to step up my game my 11th year. I hear the 11th year is when you peak. I think it's the same role, just veteran presence. I think Coach James just wants us, the veterans of the team, a few of us, just to really kind of be out front and make sure, you know, we take control of the team and make the locker room our own. And we had some good talks, and so I think the team's heading in a good direction right now.
Was it a pretty easy process? You said at the on garbage bag day that it was, you're going to walk through, yeah. Tim and wanted you, you'd sign right there?
Yeah, basically, you know, all the times I've dealt with Tim, he's been great. I just walked in and said, do you guys want me? Let me know if not. And he said, no, we want you. I said, okay. And then came back, I think, a week later, and we were done in 5 minutes. So Tammin's been straightforward. He's been great. And I just told him when I was leaving, if you ever don't want me, just let me know. Give me a day's notice. He said, I will. But you tell me if you don't want us. I said, well, I don't think that's going to happen. So you'll probably have to fire me someday.
Part of the allure of potentially coming back is potentially getting to play in a Grey Cup game here.
Yeah, it's all about that. I mean, it's, you know, going to your 11th year, I don't think you're, you know, you're looking ahead to a bunch of all-star nominations and things like that. It's just about getting another ring. I've got one. And you know, it's for myself, but also for a lot of guys in the team who don't have one, like the Dresslers and the Bags and those guys. You know, I'd love to see them get one as well, so I'd like to be a part of that.
What about a new position coach this year?
Well, new position coach, but not a new coach. You know, I felt bad for Alex, but that's the name of the game, right? Coaches and players have to move on at some point, and I wish him the best, but, you know, we're looking ahead to next year, and Richie Hall is going to be here, and Rich and I go way back, so I think it'll be good.
Considering Smith had been here pretty much your whole career, will it be a little weird?
Yeah, it'll be a little different, you know. It's but you know, I've had Richie pretty much, you know, almost my entire career. This is my 9th year with Richie, so it's not much difference for me.
The loss of Craig Dickinson as a special teams coach.
I think it's a huge loss. I think that one's really going to hurt. I think he's one of the best coaches in this league, to be perfectly honest with you, and I told him so. But sometimes that just happens, you know, and he moved on, and we got to kind of just regroup. But it is going to be a big loss. So.
What did he do as a special teams coach? I mean, it's so special.
I just thought his schemes and the way he dealt with guys, you know, and individually and as a whole, he did a really nice job. I think most of the guys on this team will tell you that. They thought a lot of Craig, and you know, we're going to miss him, but, you know, it's on to the next phase of all of our careers.
Your road to the Riders was a little different than Neil, but, I mean, you both made a double-digit career here as Canadians. So, I mean, what does it mean for you guys to... you know, to be signing on this day and to be at this level of having a career like this for this long?
Well, let's not talk about Neil during my time, okay? he'll have his time. It's huge. I mean, you know, Neil's the mayor of Regina, so I'm just a small fry from the East Coast, and coming here, I'm just trying to do what Neil does, because Neil's the man.
But for yourself, to be able to go this long and to participate in a sport you love, I mean, a lot of people don't get this chance.
Yeah, it's lucky. Like, I've talked to a couple of guys. It's kind of fluky, just, you know, staying healthy. I've missed many games. And so a lot of times guys' careers end because they get hurt, and sometimes guys get hurt and they just keep getting hurt. It's just luck of the draw, and I've been very, very lucky. So, you know, not having missed many games, you know, I've been around a lot, so I've got a decent track record.
You want to come in and compete for a starting job this year? Or is
that... I think most of us know we can stop this little game. you know, I'm there because I can provide a lot of things, and coach knows what I can do in different situations. I think I'm kind of like the wild card, so if something does happen, they can fit me in multiple positions. And I don't think they have any plans of having me be a starter. I think I'm there to maybe push guys to help make them better, whether it's in the classroom or on the field, because I know what I'm doing out there. But By no means do I feel like I'm going to be slated for a chance at a starting role, but you know, that's what you go in every camp, and you know, just work your hardest, and you never know. But I think my role on this team is to kind of just help other guys and fill in when needed.